This is an overview video, College Trigonometry, Version 3, from Stitz and Zeiger, Chapter 10, Foundations of Trigonometry, Section 10.1, the first part, Angles and Their Measure. In the study of measurements of angles, you will start off with a ray. This is an example of a ray with an initial point P. If you have two rays starting at the same point, that point is called the vertex, and that will create an angle. So, for example, this is an angle with vertex Q. You can have a straight angle, and then you can also have these two rays can create this angle, which would be an acute angle, and this angle, which is an obtuse angle. The way angles are measured are with Greek letters. So here we see alpha is the measurement of the acute angle, and beta is the measurement of the obtuse angle. One of the most common methods is using degrees. What you will see is one full revolution around a circle is 360 degrees. A straight angle would measure 180 degrees. Here we have the right angle, that is 90 degrees, and this little square symbol is very common for the 90 degree right angles. Here we have 240 degrees, that's an obtuse angle. Here we have a 30 degree acute angle, and then here, this is a 0 degree angle. When precision is important, not only do you have degrees, but you can also go to decimal degrees. Or another form is with degrees, right here, minutes and seconds. The key to that is the fact that 60 minutes equals 1 degree, and 60 seconds equals 1 minute. So these conversion factors are used to convert from decimal degrees to degrees, minutes, seconds, and also from degrees, minutes, seconds to decimal degrees. And you will see examples in the book as well as in other videos. You will also learn about certain types of angles. For example, if two angles add up to 180 degrees, or makes a straight angle, they're called supplementary angles. If two angles add up to 90 degrees, they're called complementary angles. This is theta, and this is gamma. These are also common letters in Greek for measurements of angles. Now we have standard form. If it's in standard position, if you have an angle in standard position, the initial side will always be, usually you'll see an XY coordinate system here, and it'll be the right side of the x-axis. So here we have the initial side as well. When you measure a positive angle, you will be going counterclockwise, and the ray that it ends on is called the terminal side. A negative angle is clockwise, and again here we have the terminal side. You will see the negative 45 degrees or 45, so you know when you graph those to know to go counterclockwise or clockwise. When it comes to graphing angles, if the angle is more than 450 degrees, you will see the graph will go more than one time around and then end on the terminal side. Now if you have two angles that end, they have the same coterminal side, they have the same terminal side. They're called coterminal angles. So these two are coterminal. They're drawn in standard position. And here we have 540 degrees. Here we have negative 750 degrees. Again, standard position. Another very common way to measure, not degrees, but in radians. Pi is defined, it is very common in radians, and it's defined as the circumference divided by the diameter. This gives rise to C equals pi d, or C equals 2 pi r. These are formulas you are likely very familiar with, and they're both used a lot in this book. Now the radian measure, when we're measuring, here's theta, we have a radius. This is called the arc length, and it's denoted S. Not a Greek letter, it's a distance. And we have theta equals S over R. This is starting to get us into radian measure. So here we have alpha, radian measure 1. So if you have radius r and the arc length is also r, what makes that is 1 radian. There's 1, 2, 3, 4 radians. Now, radians are usually either in pi. You'll see a lot of pi fourths, a lot of pi halves. There's pi thirds and pi sixths. This is clockwise, so it's positive. That's 9 pi fourths, again, standard position. Counterclockwise, that would be negative 5 pi halves. Now, a full rotation is 2 pi, so a straight angle is pi. To convert from degrees to radians, what's important to know is that 180 degrees, which is a straight angle, is pi radians, which is again a straight angle. So these are the same angle measured in different in radians or degrees. So you can convert from radians to degrees or from degrees to radians using this conversion factor. And this is an overview of the first part of this section.